Maybe it was a bad idea that I'd decided to finish my table fuck before tending to Dan and finding out the true meaning behind his hurt expression earlier. I'd let the foreign guy who had approached me ram his dick inside me until his mouth opened in a wide O shape and he released himself. Some of his cum shooting into my cunt and the rest onto my stomach after he pulled out. The jovial feeling I'd had a few minutes earlier died away when I saw Dan standing against the wall, looking at me so sadly. I kept asking myself, why didn't he join in? There were 10 other guys in the room, and all of them alternated clockwise around the table, taking their turn at one of us 7 women lying on the table. Why didn't he participate? After I cleaned myself off with a white towel provided to us by naked maids surrounding the mansion, I put my clothes in a boxed compartment set aside for participants' belongings. Then I trekked through the house, butt naked, looking for Dan. I didn't see when he'd walked out, and I was driving myself crazy with worry over what type of retaliation he had planned for me. As I walked through the sliding doors leading to the backyard, just as my friend Karen rushed inside, when she saw me, she squinted her eyes, said, "Darlene?" As if someone stole my face and she wasn't sure it was me. I was so shocked to see her that I yelped with excitement. I even wrapped my arms around her shoulders and gave her a hug. With the way I was feeling, because of Dan, it felt nice to see someone else at the party enjoying theirself. I was going to ask her if Mitch or Susanna was around, but before I could say anything, she told me she had to use the bathroom and dashed off. I wondered what could have caused her to rush away like she did. Usually, she's a naturally chatty Kathy. However, when I walked outside, I spotted the obvious source of Karen's mad dash. My friend Susanna was completely naked and on the lap of Karen's fuck buddy, John. He was kneeling, his knees burrowed in the grass, pumping while her breasts bounced up and down more than basketballs at the NBA Finals. Her head was laid back on his shoulder, and his arms were securely wrapped around her stomach. At first, I really couldn't understand why Karen would get so choked up over a mere FB. But when I saw that massive cock of his sliding deep and easily in and out of Susanna, I understood why. Jealousy. I figured I'd feel the same way, especially when he reached his hand down and fiercely rotated his fingertips at the top of her clit while grinding her. Who wouldn't want to fuck like that? "She takes it like a big girl, doesn't she?" a man said from behind me. I turned around, and there was Mitch. I did another yelp and hugged him too, only he didn't immediately let go of me. Our bare skin connected, our bodies exchanging heat, and I soon felt his manly tool pulsing against my leg. I pulled away from him a little, feeling somewhat uneasy by our newfound relationship. When I asked him what was wrong with Karen, he simply nodded his head in Susanna and John's direction. He told me that they'd been fucking strong since he'd arrived, so I could only assume that Susanna was hogging his dick, like she usually does everything else. I had such sympathy for my friend, even though I knew it was foolish of Karen to be jealous of her fuck buddy's actions, especially when she's the one who invited him to the orgy party. However, that didn't mean Susanna had to take over his dick. And, well, seeing as how that night was my time for sexual exploration, I was determined to make things right by taking John's fat dick right out from under Susanna. Literally. I grabbed Mitch's hand and led him across the lawn to Susanna and John. He followed like an obedient puppy, increasing my sense of power and control. When John saw me and Mitch, his upward pumps inside her slowed. They tamed to a mild grinding motion. While my breasts aren't as large as Susanna's, my body isn't either, and most guys love my petite body. My curvy hips and rotund breasts grabbed his attention almost immediately. In the midst of their action, Susanna's eyes remained closed, so she neglected to see my naked introduction to John. He bent her over slowly, and she followed his lead, never noticing anything. With one hand on her back, John used the other to take me by the hand and pull me to him. I motioned for Mitch to take John's place, and he moved more eagerly than I'd expected him to when John eased out of her pussy. The moment he took his hand off her back, Mitch was easing his cock inside her. She moaned, "Oh, fuck," and slowly swayed her hips left and right as Mitch found his rhythm. John was an expert fucker, moved with just as much confidence as Mitch when he got down on his knees, stuck out his tongue, and trailed it from my belly button down to the top of my pussy. His wet tongue tickled me, a prickling sensation sweeping throughout my pelvis. I giggled, and that's when Susanna opened her eyes, realizing that a different dick was inside her. On her knees, she turned her head, looking behind her, saw Mitch winding his spine like a snake as he massaged her pussy lips with his cock. "Oh no," she said to him, and he took her off guard when he pulled his dick out of her cunt and then eased it into her asshole. I laughed when her eyes bugged and she made a whoa sound. She dropped her head, her shoulders relaxing as Mitch's spine began to move in a snake-like motion, pleasing her more than she'd expected, or maybe even wanted. I lost all focus and interest in Susanna and Mitch when John pushed his pointer and middle finger up inside of my box. My juice is sliding down his fingers and hand before his fingers could fully disappear inside of me. My legs instantly went limp and I collapsed onto my knees. John held me by my waist and softly whispered in my ear, "I'm gonna make you scream." I lied on my back, the grass soft beneath my skin, and he wasted no time lining up the head of his dick with my slit as he pushed himself deep with perfected effortlessness. I instantly started moaning. My cunt lips spread wider and wider with each pass his cock made into my wet folds. I took all of his meat inside me, the wonderful ache of his passiveness turning from a painful pressure to a pleasurable ripple of fire in my clit. The fire was like an itch, and the more he fucked me, the more I needed the fire tamed, the itch scratched. John looked down at me, his hair cascading from his head when he told me, "Your pussy's loose." He gave me a little smirk, and it was sexy. What was even more sexy was when he bent down and our lips touched. He slid his tongue around in my mouth as his cock rushed inside of my cunt over and over again. No, Dan had never made me feel this way before. "Hey," John yelled for Mitch. It was like some telepathic communication. Instantly, Mitch caught on to whatever the hell John meant and eased out of Susanna, who didn't try to hide the fury in her eyes. I was stealing the cock she thought she owned, and his dick was so heavy, so gooey, as he jacked it off in long strokes and walked over to me and Karen's FB. Switching positions, John lied down on his back and had me straddle him. He kept his hands on my hips, and they were so warm. They comforted me more than I would have imagined. He was so rock hard that he didn't need to use his hands to guide his beefy dick inside my cunt. In no time, Mitch climbed on top of me and John. A trickling trickle of lube oozed onto my asshole, and Mitch massaged it around my tight hole while John kept fucking my pussy and spreading my flower wider and wider with each entry he penetrated me with. Delicately, Mitch eased one finger into my asshole, and I gasped from the painful pleasure of it. He pulled his finger out and then eased it back inside me, even made twisting motions with his finger as he did it. I squirmed with so much delight and hoisted my ass higher. Then, without warning, Mitch stopped paying attention to my asshole. His hard pectorals pressed against my back as he pulled the skin on his dick back, making his cock hard and straight, and then I felt the tip of his dick pushing into my clit. John's cock was wedged deep inside me, but he'd stopped himself moving long enough for Mitch to slide himself inside my pussy. My legs were spread so wide that I was almost doing splits. Mitch's thighs pressed firmly against my sides as he squat on top of both me and John. I didn't expect to enjoy John so much. I was caught up in the excitement of the night and the danger of what might happen when or if Karen popped up. Suddenly, Susanna stood in front of me and put both her hands on the top of my head for balance. Then she slowly sat down on John's face, her big, sloppy breasts jiggling in my eyesight. But what sent adrenaline rushing through my body was when John eagerly stuck out his tongue, waiting for her. I could only imagine how Karen would react to Susanna feeding him her twat while I rode his cock with oomph. However, two words came to mind. Fucking furious.